So I don't know if this is part two, and you know, take it for what it is. Probably only one or two people, or no one will watch this. But you know what? Just a note to myself. I want to remind myself that I said in the other recording that I'm gonna create, mention a dream, and I don't think I ever did. So I'm not gonna type it up. It's too much, and it's not the same. So I'm gonna discuss this. I believe that the reason why I've been also emphasizing Isaiah 27 and 28 is because, and the next coming seal, and that the Father has of course told me, not only that he's been reminding me of my oath to him that I have made in front of him in third heaven, where Jesus Christ of Nazareth and the four archangels, throne angels, are always with him in front of the 24 elderly council, because one of those people in elderly council is Enoch. And Enoch, as you know, was one of those who got raptured and who came, who was then later the one who was sent out to speak, who was shown by Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth himself and then Archangel. I would think it was, wasn't it Gabriel, about a certain, how the earth works, how the sun works and follows its very specific circular circuit that Father has designed it. Circuit. So here's Earth. Psalm 148 and Psalm 150 say specifically that the Earth is under a firmament, that the Earth is referred to as what? A plane on columns. Also, Psalm 19 refers to the Earth and the sun, that the sun comes out of its gate like the bridegroom. Okay? And that it has a circuit, that the sun follows its what? Circuit. Circuit. Circuit is by definition. Go look up the definition of the word circuit. And I'm going to draw you a knot, but it goes like this. Horizontal to the earth. That's the circuit of the sun, which means what? That the sun goes around the earth. Earth is not what you've been told in schools, brothers and sisters, okay? Earth is not per se flat, but it sure is not a globe. The Bible says that the earth has columns, that the earth has firmament. The firmament has what? Portals, three portals to the east and three portals to the west that Father has opened to cause the flood from the waters above, and then he opened up the portals at the bottom of the seas to flood the earth. So the water was coming out from the bottom and the top plus the rain. That's why out of nowhere all this water came. Do you understand? And the way this water comes out of nowhere can also disappear and everything can go back to normal. This is why the net breaking of the next seal is so crucial and important, because in seal 6, who comes out? That's when you have the angel, I believe it's Archangel Uriel, that will be sent back down to the earth with the key to the pit of hell, and he will let out Abaddon out of hell. That's seal 6. Earth is under the water. Three quarters of the earth is under the water, is being flooded regularly. No one in the United States is telling you this. In fact, none of the other channels all over the world are discussing that three quarters of the world are under the water, which means what? A year from now, everybody will be starving. That's just what it is, and that is part of the prophecy. Nobody in the world is discussing. Everybody thinks that you're looking up to the enemy where they think they are in a timeline, and what they think and what reality truly is are two different things. Because remember, Satan did change the original calendar that Heavenly Father, God Almighty, has established, which was the Enochian calendar, and that was altered. And then the Romans established the Gregorian and the Julian calendar, where they celebrate the 12 heathen months of the year. And, you know, they basically, I think they added on days. What I'm saying is this. Listen to me. Every seventh day, Friday evening to Saturday, take a day off. Spend that time in reading scripture. Don't do any work. Get your food ready if you can, or order takeout. And so you can just like pay for it through your cell phone, and that's it. That's the time to worship, sing songs, hang out, listen to some sermons, fellowship with people online, etc. That's what the seventh day off is supposed to be, for you to fellowship with Jesus Christ of Nazareth first and foremost, prayer, worship, having fun, being with Jesus, getting to know him. That's why he commanded the seventh day off. And that's it. That means you are obedient. Did you know that? Don't do it on a Sunday. Okay, I wouldn't do it on a Sunday. It's just not what Father told. I'm a Gentile and I'm a Gentile bride, but he still told me to celebrate the seventh day off on the Saturday. You don't have to necessarily do it Friday to Saturday, but at least Saturday, starting early in the morning, you know, that's the day you must have off. The reason why people, why the Jews were celebrating, because, from the day evening, from the sundown the day before, like Friday sundown to sundown the next day, Saturday, is because Jewish calendar counts their days from the moment sun goes down and when the sun comes up. Do you know that? You didn't know that? Well, now you do know. So that's the only reason why Jews must celebrate it that way. Okay? If you're a Gentile, you don't have to. But if you follow after Jesus, then you must. I would suggest that, well, that's the proper way. That's how Father God commanded originally to all his believers to follow after his calendar. So I say you are to follow in Jesus' steps, even as a Gentile, but a Gentile believer, man or woman, child, and just do what Jesus did. If you're not sure, again, test the spirits, get on your knees and pray. Going back now quickly to the dream. Going back, I never even told you the dream. Oh my goodness. Hi, my name is Anna or Anya. Welcome to my channel. I'm so glad that you're here. Please subscribe. I know I'm rambling, but again, you don't like my rambling, you can move on to something else. I love you. Jesus loves you. God bless you. May his countenance come and shine forth upon you. I break all curses, spells, hexes, vexes, santeria, voodoo, hoodoo against you. I break those vagabonds and firebrands, lakes, links, cords, caskets, leashes, seals, devilish vials, incantations, snares of the devil. I break them against you with the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And I break them off your family and off your children and off your household, off all your temple. I break them off in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the blood of Jesus. And I establish now a permanent, and I bind every strongman, holdman, and gatekeepers, and I cast them out of your house and your bodies and the bodies of your children, family members, in the name of Jesus. And I bind them to hell for the keys to the kingdom of heaven. What I bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. That is the Matthew 16:19. For that is the keys to the kingdom of heaven. So what I bind on earth shall be bound, I decree and declare in heaven. Amen. The dream 3 years ago, maybe a little longer than this, basically showed me what today I know is a rapture, and I know it is the execution of Isaiah 27 and 28 all at the same time, or at least I'm very well aware that it's Isaiah 28. In Isaiah 28, Father God Almighty says that through his Son, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, his fist. So those of you who had dreams with a fist coming down like this, it's a fist of God that will come down and crush and thrust down to the earth all entities in second heaven that have rebelled against God. Do you understand? So I would say Satan is going down in Isaiah 28 also, which is, of course, supported by the biblical code. So I'm going to tell you this much. It is safe to say, as I prayed over this 4 months, and I do know, let's just say that Satan will be casted down, and all the hosts of heaven that has rebelled against our Heavenly Father. Anything that NASA has created at the same time is coming down. All the any kind of technology is suspended in a second heaven is going to be casted down to the earth. All of those judgments for those people whom they have tortured, the five types of people that are mentioned in Isaiah 28 that the enemy has tortured, and witches, warlock, wizards, they're going to be and they're going to be, they've been ransomed by the blood of Jesus, so the enemy had no way to touch them. And Father is judging that the witches, warlock, wizards, and all those wicked, evil occultists too. And of course, Satan and all other fallen angels, princes of hell, etc. And of course, we're going to heaven in a rapture at that point in time.